I noticed today that our count of formalized IMO solutions is at 99. So I think it'd be cool to get over that 100 milestone. So I just went through and I picked out one that looked not too difficult. This one from 1996. We're given a function on the natural numbers, the non-negative integers, or rather, we're given this constraint on such functions, and we want to determine what the form of the function is. And so I think this is an accurate formalization of that. And I'm going to be following the solution, try to follow the solution from John Scholes. The formalized version of this is going to be quite a bit longer than this English right here. Step one is to extract what the final answer is, the solution set, and that's this here. So f must be of the form qk plus nrk, where q is the quotient of dividing by k and r is the remainder of dividing by k for the input value. Like if x is the input value, q is x integer divide k, and r is just x percent k. So it's also clear that like the zero function is a solution. I think that does not satisfy this particular form. So I think what we want to do is write this as two separate cases. Let me try this. I want to say the solution set is it's the zero function or union. So it's I think if I write just zero here, I think that's the same as saying fun x maps to zero. But maybe it's clearer if I do it like that. And then let me copy over what this is. Zero function or of the form. Either it's the zero function or there exists k and a function n which maps natural numbers to natural numbers such that f equals x divided by k, so that's q times k, and then plus n times the remainder, so that's x percent k times k. And why can't I write that? N takes as its input r. You could write this n applied to r. John Scholes writes it like this. I think I'll have to also say n of 0 equals 0. I think that is accurately transcribing what John Scholes is telling me is the solution here. I guess we'll find out as we try to do the rest of the proof. So the easy direction is going to be take something in the solution set and prove that it satisfies the constraints. Constructor. One thing that I learned recently, I know how to apply code actions in Emacs now. So if I see this green underline for like simp question mark or exact question mark, with my key bindings, I do control C L A A, and then it applies the code action. I set my LSP key map prefix to control C control L. So I guess AA is the default do the code action thing, and then control C control L is the thing that I configured. Let's split in two cases for HF. The zero case should be very easy. Here we'll just say ruffle. Be fancy about it and just, you know, apply the equality everywhere. I should just be able to say simp, right? Yeah, that one's easy. If it's the zero function, it satisfies those constraints. I'm just looking again, like I just want to like double check that, like, I don't think I can choose k and n such that this thing here is equal to the zero function. I think it's like the zero function corresponds to like essentially choosing k to be infinity. I can actually do the destructuring up here. Mugurzo says k equals zero, we'll give you the zero function. K is going to be zero, so both sides, it doesn't even matter what the left-hand factors of these are going to be. If k is zero, then the right-hand side is zero. I think you're right, that I could probably get away with not having this. I think I should just be able to do that now. Sometimes I just say ASOP and it just works, but not in this case. What if I grind? No. Okay, the solution actually does, you know, spend a few sentences proving that this works. So I guess we shouldn't expect it to just be a trivial one-liner in lean. Part of my difficulty here is that I'm having two different n's. I guess we'll call this one n1. The problem with these like really succinct informal solutions is like when they say like let m equals ak plus r, like this whole thing, it's like I don't know which of these variables are being defined here. It's like this whole implicit dance that's happening of I'm introducing these new constraints and it's just like, well, the new ones I haven't mentioned yet, those are the ones that I'm defining, so I need to decipher this. Okay, so we already have m. So this is just saying we're decomposing m into its a is the quotient, r is the remainder. Similarly, we already have n, so we're decomposing n into a quotient and a remainder. This is a transitive inequality, so it's just saying r and s are greater than or equal to r, and r and s are less than k. Good, because they're both remainders. I can just say let a equal m over k, let r equal m percent k, let b equal n over k, have f of I think we're going to need, why don't I have f in my context anymore? me putting ruffle here is what made it go away. Let's call this hf1 instead, just do rewrite hf1. So there's like two things here. There's one on the left and there's this one on the right. I mean, maybe I should not have done that yet also. F is constant on multiples of k due to hn1, and f always lands in multiples of k. Okay, so f is identity. Sure, okay. I'm annoyed because like I'm not even sure if should I have a for all quantifier here. For all m. This is like the kind of thing I'm always confused about when I'm just going line by line. Because yeah, we had an m in the context, but sometimes informally you're re-quantifying. N1 of 0 equals 0. I think I agree with that. Like this. That should fix it. Thank you. So I certainly agree that f of anything is a multiple of k because I've got k on the right hand side here. So if I had to introduce an intermediate goal, something like k divides f of m, that's going to be easy. I can do that. But then how am I going to use it? So on multiples of k, it's the identity, because if it's a multiple of k, then this equals x and this equals 0. I agree. Let's just prove these as lemmas. So for all x, k divides x implies x equals x. Come on. Yes! Div mul cancel. And actually, I can just rewrite by that, I think. Nice. Okay, and then also x percent k equals 0. Pull that in here too. And then hn1 div mul. I could probably just say simp at this point. Yay. Okay, so that's half of it. The other half was for all x, k divides f of x. And this is just going to be factoring out the multiplication. See if rewrite question mark does something nice for us. Otherwise, I'll have to be a bit smarter about how I search for my lemma. Nope. Okay, I mean, what I want is just want to like undistribute the k like that. What is happening? Admul, it's just admul. I think I can just exact this, but I don't even need to like type out the terms here. Okay, so now we have these helpers that we just need to chain together. Like, I don't even need to rewrite by, like, I already, all the stuff that I need from expanding the definition is in h2 and h3, so I can just, I might as well quantify this, and then just immediately apply it to m. I mean, I keep hoping that automation is going to get it with what we have. Hey, it does. Okay, grind works. Grind is great. Next line, f of n equals b times k plus n of s times k, n1. Oh, there was the second step here. We did that first step. We need to do the second step, actually. I think it's just a definition. I think it's just like REFL. Or it like should be the definition if I've set things up right, but maybe I haven't set things up right. M and H4. Okay, that works. It should be just like subst F REFL. I think that's clearer than grind. Grind is overkill. Okay, and again, this should be subst F REFL if I wrote it out right. I guess I didn't write it out right. Definition of S is wrong. Copy-paste problems, bane of my existence. Okay, I think we want to avoid unfolding those definitions as long as we can. Let's not think about it too hard, just write it out. Yeah, what's going on here? I know how to like rewrite f of n as something. That's what h5 gives me, but then like I'm gonna get a bunch of stuff here under the application of f, and I don't know how I'm gonna get rid of it. So like, I can do rewrite h5, but then like what do I do with this? Am I required to unfold the definition of f? This is like why I don't like informal proofs. They make these leaps of logic. That word so is doing a lot of work there. What do you mean so? I guess I just multiply things out and hope things work. We can definitely reduce this part in here a little bit with the mod. Rewrite mat dot add mod. M percent k, that's r. This term is this term, that's good. We need to reduce this thing. And it looks promising. At some point, I want to just be able to say grind or omega. I don't think that's quite yet. Add div of dvd right. I think we want left. Yeah, so let's try that. What I want to say first is just k divides this. Cool. Hey, that worked. I just want to undistribute the k here. Yeah, okay, I just had to tell it to apply to the right place. Now simp should pick that up, because multiply by k, divide by k should be identity. Of course, exact can't do it. Really? Maguza, what do you got for me? You need 0, 0. Oh, okay. Why is k greater than 0? Do I just not have that? So suppose we did have that. No, but now I have the assumption that I need. Okay, just keep copying over our current state, because it's like hard to look at it over there in the info view, because it wraps wrong. Okay, that's enough. That ring will handle it. And so we do just need this k greater than 0 thing. Like maybe up here we can just say, if k equals 0, I can just mega simplify f. That works. Then I don't need to do HKP there. Okay. Although, like, I do think that we are doing something a bit messy here in the body of H6. We're supposed to be using H4 and H5 and H1, but we kind of just, like, redid those proofs in line. Whatever, it went through. Grind hit can do H8. We're done. Yeah. Grind. Don't have to think about why. Grind can often solve things that are easy. Where we are right now, we've proved the easy direction. We've proved that if f is in this solution set, then it obeys the constraints. What remains is to prove that if it obeys the constraints, then it's in the solution set. So let's get started on that. Intro hf. So we have the function, we have the constraint. We want to prove that it's in the solution set, which means we need to find k and n such that f is of this form. We just did this part. We need to do this part. It's easiest to just copy this whole text over and then do what we were doing, work through it line by line. This is basically just getting rid of one application of f. I'll take it, replace. So f of n is a fixed point. What do you mean? What is n? N is a free variable. Are you saying let f of n be a fixed point? Maybe you mean has a fixed point, but how do you know that? Informal proofs, leaps of logic. Oh, I see. So for all n, this is the implicit quantification for all n, f of n is a fixed point. Maybe I want to pull out all of these lemmas. Okay, the smallest non-zero fixed point. How do we say this? We can say, like, for the set of all fixed points greater than 0, and then that set is either empty or it has an element. I'm worried about how I'm going to set up this getting the minimum thing. Sometimes the minimum thing you do by strong induction, sometimes, I don't know, nat.min, nat.find. And then there's probably a lemma that nat.find finds the minimum thing. Find min. Yeah, okay. I guess that's going to be enough. So I think what that's telling me is that the way I've set this up should be fine. I'll just use nat.find down here. So let's deal with the zero case first. I don't even know if I want to rewrite it like that. If k does not exist, all y f of y is 0. Why is that? Okay, sometimes grind just does it. I don't need to think about it. I mean, that's kind of like the ideal case. All that I'm doing here is I'm formalizing each little step, the theorem statement of each step of the informal proof, and then the automation fills in the actual reasoning. So thank you, grind. I don't need to understand actually what just happened there. That gives us a solution. So we just use 0. Come on. I guess Aesop does it. Hey, we found it. Aesop did it and grind didn't. That was the case when the only fixed point is 0. So now we're in the case where we have a non-zero fixed point, and we're going to use nat.find to get the minimum one. So I give it a proposition of the form exists npn. I'm going to give it hfp. Needs to be what? If I did have k, that just like forgets how I got k, and I'm not going to be able to prove anything about it. If I do let, then I can use the fact that it's defined by nat.find. Why does this take so long? It's taking like half a second. I guess I'm going to use hf once. Find spec. Cool. I should do that up here. There's something slow in my proof. I think it might be the Aesop. HK 0. So now we have these two facts. 0 is less than k. There, that's in the form that we want. 0 is less than k and f of k equals k. I think we're going to use hf to like unfold once. And then I guess we turn k into f of k so that we can apply this. That seems like the only thing I can do. Seems promising, I guess. It worked. It was an easy induction. So now let n be another fixed point. What am I trying to prove here? Fixed points are precisely the multiples of k. For all n, n is a fixed point if and only if n is a multiple of k. Hf for all n, f of n equals n if and only if. I already have h3 tells me that multiples of k are fixed points. What I need to prove here is the other direction, that fixed points are multiples of k. Then k divides n. So n is another fixed point, and then there's going to be something called like div add mod. Ugh, I've got to commute the multiplication. The informal proof goes qk and then it goes kq, just to make it a little bit more annoying for me to write the formal proof. Why is my CPU fan getting so loud? Is the grind really expensive? Yeah, we're not gonna grind there. Grind does it, but it's a little bit slow. I kind of don't want to be accumulating grind steps that each take like half a second or 1 second, because that's how you end up with a very slow proof. I guess I just combine all these things. I guess I can just make this big calc block. Calc blocks, they just have the weirdest indentation rules. It was unhappy with me if my stuff was to the left of that equals there. I need to use Feynman again. I mean, I already used it for K. I have HK0 and HFK. Find spec, oh, okay. Let me see what Feynman is. Fem is less than fine, then it's not true. So do I have that this is less than K? Or I'm using like a contrapositive or something here? Like, R is by definition less than K, okay. Mod LT, Feynman of HFPHR. Grind. The reason all these grinds are like a little bit slow is that there's just a lot in our context. No. I want a not and to turn into an or of not. Okay, let me at H8 and then apply that. H8 of H6. I'm fine with that. Okay, so why does K divide N? Oh, because R is 0, it's an HND. Okay. I feel like I'm just gonna exact here and it's gonna work. Maybe you're saying I didn't even need to like rewrite because of definitional equality. No, I see, I just didn't even use that. Okay. I'm still annoyed because something in my proof here is getting kind of slow. The whole thing takes 1.5 seconds. Yeah, that might be the grind. Might be a grind. It might be this grind. I'm gonna not worry about it for now. I think it's bearable at the moment. Anyway, we just closed this branch here where we showed that if n is a fixed point, then k divides n. Indentation is wrong. Okay, so we just use H4 and HM. I want to compose them manually. So I guess apply H4. Okay. How does this work? How do these pieces come together? K is K. That's clear. What do we do for N though? Well, I think that makes sense. N equals F. Let's bash it through, see if it works. What do I do? X. Another div add mod, that's fine. And then we use HF, I guess. And then the point is that one of these, m plus fn, so like one of these terms here is f of n for some n. And I guess it's this one because it's a multiple of k. Maybe I'll do nth, rewrite one. I didn't realize I was doing it more than once. I think a behavior changed recently in lean where like it used to be that rewrite would only apply once, but now it applies to everywhere it matches. I think I see what I want to do. I don't like doing all these nth rewrites, but I feel like I'm so close to the end that I just want to push through. Now we can do HF. Ha, I think that helps. I'm a bit worried because I'm seeing like this feels like it wants to line up with this, but this has an extra factor of K. Yeah, I think this is working except for this extra factor of K here. Like this is again a factor of K, so we should use H3 and rewrite that to get rid of the application of F, so then it's just like this term will equal this term, and then we're left with f of x mod k equals f of x mod k times k. So that doesn't work. N of x, f of x over k. This is where we need that k divides f of n, because this is going to let these k's cancel. Okay, this is looking very promising. I think we're almost there. Let's do the term that we knew about already first. So let's cancel these terms. Rewrite H3. Nice. Okay, so I just need to show, let's just split this out. What if I just try exact? Okay, we got it because of H10. Wait, not even H10. What's going on? Well, H10 is just H4. Okay, so fine. We can clean that up. I just want to get to the end. There's going to be like two more steps here. And then ring. I think that does it. Goals accomplished. No sorries. Thank you, everyone. This was great. Thank you very much, Maguzo, for the help. So I'm gonna push this as is, and then in a few minutes, the website will update, and we will look at that and rejoice in our achievement, which we have unlocked. This should change to 100 when I reload. Yay, we did it.